comedians doubt Trump's claim he would run in there to save kids. President Donald Trump on Monday provided more fodder to his critics, especially those on the late-night TV circuit, by criticizing the officer who allegedly stayed outside during the Parkland, Florida, school shooting, claiming that he would have run in there to stop the shooter. "You know, I really believe, you don't know until you're tested, but I really believe I'd run in there, even if..."
The president called the NRA leaders patriots, but he insisted he's not afraid to oppose them.
"And I want to tell you, they want to do something. And I said, fellas, we got to do something. It's too long now. We got to do something. Don't worry about the NRA. They're on our side. You guys, half of you are so afraid of the NRA. There's nothing to be afraid of. And you know what? If they're not with you, we have to fight them every once in a while. That's okay."
And one idea the president has embraced would require a fight, a plan to raise the minimum age for buying a rifle from 18 to 21. The NRA opposes the idea, and since their lunch with the president, he hasn't mentioned it either.
"In concept, the president still supports it, but in terms of legislation, we'd need to see what that looks like before we weigh in further."
The idea the president seems most enthusiastic about remains allowing qualified teachers and school officials to carry concealed weapons to school.
"I want highly trained people that have a natural talent, like hitting a baseball or hitting a golf ball or putting."
But the governor of Washington State, Democrat Jay Inslee, rose to confront the president.
"I've listened to the first grade teachers that don't want to be pistol packing first grade teachers. We need to listen that educators should educate, and they should not be foisted upon this responsibility of packing heat in first grade classes. So I just suggest we need a little less tweeting here, a little more listening."
The president immediately turned to Republican Greg Abbott, governor of Texas, one of a handful of states that allows qualified teachers to carry concealed weapons. Abbott said some schools actually have warning signs like this one out front,
warning anybody coming on there that if they attempt to cause any harm, they're going to be in trouble.
"If I didn't have a weapon, and I think most of the people in this room would have done that too," Trump said. Trump, who called the officer's alleged behavior disgusting, made the comments while speaking with governors from across the nation on gun control. "At this point, I go to bed every night believing there's nothing he could say or do that could possibly surprise me. Then the sun comes up," said the Late Show host Stephen Colbert, before showing his audience the aforementioned clip. "There's a lot there I doubt, but the part I really don't believe is that he can run. Sir, we already know how you react to combat situations," Colbert added. "You got 5 deferments from Vietnam." Seth Meyers on Late Night reacted similarly to the president's comments. "Nothing about that is believable. Forget running into a school to confront the shooter. I don't believe you'd run anywhere, period," Meyers said. "You can't even be bothered to walk down a flight of stairs. There's really nothing worse than a fake tough guy. Trump lives in a fantasy world where he's some sort of action movie star who'd rush into danger and save the day." Meanwhile, Trevor Noah, host of The Daily Show, tried to point out the bright side of Trump's comments. "To be fair," Noah said, "if Donald Trump ran into a school during a shooting, I do believe he would stop the shooting. Imagine you're a school shooter and Donald Trump appears in the hallway. How distracting would that be? That's right, it's me, Donald Trump. I don't have a gun, but what I do have is an amazing Electoral College victory," said Noah, doing his best Trump impersonation. Then, like 8 minutes later, the police show up and Trump is still talking.